family, friends, loved ones.
Welcome
to Grace Online. My name is Joshua Harris.
And I am Alexis Johnson.
And we are with the Worship Arts and Media Team Ministry here at Grace for the Nations Church. And we got some news for you.
Yes, we do. We are here to share with you ways to stay connected. What did I say?
Connected.
Ways to stay connected, absolutely. And we want to share those ways so that you won't miss anything that's going on with Grace. We know we've been doing this online church ministry for some time. So we want to make sure all of our newcomers and maybe our, you know, friends and family who've been here for a while, that you guys do not forget the ways to how to stay connected to Grace. We don't want you to miss anything. So what's one of those ways?
One of the prominent ways, old-fashioned ways, but it's a good way. It's by calling us, okay? The number
ring
is right there, okay? The number's right here, so give us a call. Any of the needs that you may have, it could be prayer requests, it could be information about, you know, some of the ministry teams and different things that we got going on.
Mm-hmm.
But call us. We want to hear from you.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Another one of those ways will be to join all of our social media platforms. You can like us on Facebook. You can follow us on Instagram. There we'll have inspirational videos, quotes, little clips from our services, upcoming events that you don't want to miss at Grace. And this is a great way, again, to stay connected to Grace. You don't want to miss it. Tell your family, your friends, your uncles, your cousins, your aunties, all of them, your coworkers, everybody, okay? Because we want to make sure that you are connected and you don't miss a thing.
Once again, tell your friend, tell a friend, tell another friend, tell that friend, tell his mama's friend, and then that mama's friend, tell the daddy friend, tell all your friends about Grace for the Nations Church. But also, we have a website. Yes, it's 2022. We have a website. www.gftnc.org is where you can get even more information about our service times, about some of the small groups that we have going on. But also, we got a podcast, y'all. We've been had a podcast. Touched by Grace on Apple Podcasts. You can get more information on the website, okay? And also, you can join Grace by going on the website, you know, stay connected and everything. So those are some of the additional ways, but I think we got a couple more. So let's go ahead back with Alexis. We got what, the social media?
Yep.
With Facebook,
mm-hmm.
Instagram.
That's right.
I thought I saw that we was on TikTok low key for this.
Oh yeah, can't forget, for the younger kids and even the older kids at heart, we on TikTok. So be sure to check out some videos, some fun little videos, some scripture references, clips again from our services. We're on TikTok, so you don't want to miss that.
Yep, YouTube.
YouTube.
We already said Facebook, the website.
Absolutely, the website and the prayer number. That's going to be on the bottom of the screen right here,
number,
just in case you missed it. So thank you so much for tuning in to Grace Online. And these are ways to stay connected to Grace.
So we say, I'm going to sing,
I'm going to sing
in the middle of the storm,
the of the storm.
Louder and louder,
louder and louder,
you're going to hear my praises,
hear my praises.
Up from the ashes,
up from the ashes,
hope will arise,
hope will arise.
The death is defeated,
death is defeated.
The King is alive.
The King is alive.
Say, I raise a
hallelujah.
With everything inside of me,
with everything inside of me,
With us. I raise a hallelujah. Fear you lost your hold on me. Let's take it to the chorus. Sing it. I'm gonna sing. In the middle. Louder and louder. You're gonna hear my praise roar. From the ashes. Hope will arise. Somebody declare it today. The King is alive. King say right there. Alive. I'm gonna sing.
I'm gonna sing.
In the middle. I'm gonna sing louder than the unbelief say. Cause my weapon is my melody, yeah. And heaven comes to fight for me, say.
Sing a little louder.
With everything inside of me, yeah.
Sing a little louder.
And I will watch the darkness flee, yeah.
Sing a little louder.
In the middle. Sing it out. Sing it.
I'm gonna sing.
In the middle. Come on. Louder and louder.
Louder, and louder.
You're gonna hear.
You're gonna hear my praises.
Up from the ashes.
Up from the ashes.
Hope will arise.
Hope will arise.
Come on. Release it today. The King. Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
I'm gonna sing a little louder.
I'm
gonna sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Come on, say, sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. Come on, musicians, let's bless the Lord. Come on, lift your voice right where you are. Let's give them the glory. Let's give them the honor. And we won't lose our song. We'll keep on singing. Hey, I'll keep on singing. Woo! I'll keep on singing. Come on, sing it with us. Say, keep on singing.
Keep on singing.
Keep on singing.
Keep on singing.
Sing a
Sing your song to him. I'll keep on singing.
Let me share something with you, man of God. And the Lord shared this with me in similar fashion. Like, man, I thought I should be more, you know, my 401k should be off the chain by now. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, I know what it's like to lose $100,000 in the stock market of money that I didn't have to lose. You know what I'm saying? And so that's discouraging. You were talking about being depressed. You know? But to answer your question, I'm going to share with you something that I shared years ago. And I want to talk about the degree of disappointment. The degree of disappointment that you experience as a believer is the distance between what you expect and God's reality. I'm going to say that again. The degree to which you experience disappointment is the gap or the chasm or the distance between what your expectations are and what God's expectations are. And when you align your expectations with God's expectations, you find that the gap is shortened, right? And so to answer your question, how do you address that feeling of not being where you should be in terms of what your mind's eye drew the picture of? Am I understanding that correctly? Mm-hmm. Understand God can do anything at any time. And it's never too late. I'm reminded of Caleb in scripture. Give me my mountain, bro. I'm 80. You know what I'm saying? Give me my mountain. You know what I'm saying? And God honored his request because he still could fight. You know what I'm saying? Even though he was up in age. Do you know what I'm saying? So we look at the framework of seasons and time in comparison to again, you got to look, where did the idea for your dream come from? It came from seeing what you perceive success is, right? And when you see and you draw in your mind's eye, that picture comes from somewhere. So the question is, where did you draw the picture? Because success from God's perspective may be different from the world's perspective. Make sense?
I'd also like to say, along with that is, when I get this question, when I've had this question, what I do is I do a deep dive on the desire. And Corey, Pastor Corey talked about, you know, the DREAM acronym, dominant, recurring, expectation, aspiration, motivation, or expectation, affirmation, motivation. It's that thing that keeps coming up in your heart. So a couple things, and Pastor Corey just said it, but remember, even in the word of the Lord, tonight, God lives outside of time. Time is a construct that was created to basically for us. But God lives outside of time. In other words, he controls time. He's not time bound, in other words. So it is actually, if God can stop the sun and start it up again, has the power to do that, then God can get whatever your heart's desire is to you in a 2-minute window or a 20-year window.
Yeah.
But all he wants to know is, do you have faith in him that he can do it? Because faith actually says, I already have it. Literal faith says that faith is now. Meaning, when you prayed about the dream and you did it from your heart, you actually already have it. But it maybe hasn't manifested in the natural yet. But that's why when we praise like we do here, it's basically I'm praising you like it's already right here, right now. But I'm going to trust you as I walk out the process. And then there's the concept of what we call the match made in heaven, which is faith. It's very important. And Pastor Corey did a phenomenal teaching on that. But patience is also equally important. Faith and patience are the match made in heaven.
Oh, talking about that what you shared with me, faith, foolishness, and presumption.
So that kind of gets to, there's a book out by Dr. Price, who went on to be with the Lord. And faith, foolishness, and presumption really speaks to motive, but not in a negative way, meaning, what is it that you really want, and why do you want it? And then, because, you know, you might have, for example, it was real popular when the Word of Faith movement first began was, you know, you hear a story, somebody said, I gave away my car. And God, and God, you know, blessed me with a Rolls Royce 2 weeks later. So you have people, God did not tell you to do that. Did tell you to do that.
Right.
He might have told you to do that, or you felt led to do it. That's where your faith was. But you had people going, you know, giving away life savings and doing things and expect, I'm going to get 100-fold return. You can't even believe for 1-fold return right now. But you believe and you're going to give away your house and God going to give you 10 mansions. So faithfulness presumption basically says at the end of the day, God can blow your mind on anything you believe him for. He said, if thou can just believe, all things are possible, then believe it. But that's the key. What what I wanted everybody to get tonight was how powerful to glory to God the teaching was, meaning that's why you get excited about getting in the Word, because you only really have as much faith as much Word. Your level of faith is legitimately the Word that you have in you, because you can't believe God beyond His Word, because faith, He said it. The scripture, He quoted the scripture. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And that word is, in the Greek, is actually rhema. So you got the logos written, hard copy word, but then you got a word that God spoke to you. And He can speak to you on a word that's logos, but it has to be faith in you. Meaning, that's why I get excited about speaking and calling those things to be not as though they were, because I'm building a foundation over time. To where when it comes to the point where you need faith to believe for somebody to get a certain blessing, a healing, or whatever, you have it in you, because you literally cannot believe God beyond the word that you know of Him. I'm not saying God can't bless you and it can't be sovereign and mercy and those things. But when you realize, for example, I don't struggle with condemnation. You know why? Not because I'm all of that. And I do make mistakes. I sin and have to acknowledge it to God. But I have so much revelation that the blood of Jesus has paid it all. Yeah. He is my redemption. So, Satan, you could go jump in the cold lake. Okay? I'm not going to take back my faith just because I made a mistake. It doesn't matter what it is. I literally have a revelation, meaning I have insight. So, like, we talked about this, Pastor Corey. When you're trying to believe for somebody to just say get saved or to see something, in the natural, you thinking, now he know 2 + 2 = 4. Why is he saying 2 + 2 = 8? Why is he saying, 2 + 2 = 3? They don't have revelation. I'm talking about of a concept. If you're trying to get somebody to receive Christ, they don't see it yet. But when you get revelation and you get that word and that light turns on, you like, oh, and then that becomes unshakable. See, that's what you want to do. So the reason that you speak things over yourself about your future, about what you're believing for, is because, to be honest with you, we all need to hear the word from anointed pastors and preachers and teachers. But the real word you need to hear is you need to hear you say it. Because you're going to believe you.
Ooh, let me tell you something. One of the seasons in my life, you know how the scripture said David encouraged himself? And I couldn't find nobody to encourage me. Trust me, I was down, I was discouraged, and I was depressed. One of the most powerful things that I ever personally did was I encouraged myself in the mirror. I kid you not. You want to talk about something hitting your spirit, hitting your soul? Encourage yourself. Speak the word of God in a mirror, literally in the mirror, and you'll feel it. I kid you not. You will feel it. Hit your spirit, man, to the point where you get uncomfortable and you back up. That's how powerful the word of God is. I kid you not. If you can't find anybody to encourage you, if you can't find anybody to get in your winner's circle, encourage yourself. Get in the mirror and speak the scriptures. Speak God's promises over your life. And you'll find it, that word hits your spirit and it begins to change your inner man. I kid you not. I did it myself and it's scary. It's a good scary. To feel, but you can feel the power of God and the word of God literally hit your life. Don't you know the word of God is alive? It ain't nothing to play. The word of God ain't for play. It's real.
That's right.
It is so real. Can I tell you how bad God's word is? Yes. You want a revelation of God's word? You know how the Bible says in the beginning was the word, word was with God, and the word was God? Do you know that the word is the actual word? They couldn't define what the word was. I know I'm talking too fast, but watch me walk, right? It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and without anything made was made, right? Where is in the beginning? Genesis, right? In the beginning, in Hebrew, it says, Bereshith bara. In the beginning, Bereshith bara. There is a word that the rabbis could not translate in Hebrew. And that's what's called the Word. Do you want to know what the Word is? It is Aleph. Or Alpha and Omega. It's a two symbol word. If you look at a Torah scroll in Genesis 1, there's a word that can't translate, and you'll see two symbols, Aleph Tav, right? Aleph Tav, or Alpha Omega. Jesus says, what? I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. He who is, who was, and is to come, the Almighty. And the God says, Jesus tells you himself that he's God. How do they say, well, Jesus ain't God. Jesus tells you himself that he's God. And then he says, I am who is, who was, and is to come. I am the Almighty, right? I'm the Alpha and Omega. When he says I'm the Alpha and Omega, he's telling you what the word was in Genesis 1. That I left tied that wasn't translated, right? In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word what? Was God. That's how bad God is, right? Now, that's not any private revelation that I got. I mean, God showed me that, but you can have that same type of revelation experience by consistently being in his word. Watch what I tell you. When you study God's word, it's like a compound effect.
Yes.
It's like building a snowball.
Yes.
And the antithesis is, if you negate the word of God, and you don't read the word of God, it's like your snowball will melt to nothing. The Bible says it like this. To him that hath,
yes,
much will be given.
Yes.
And to him that hath not understanding will be taken away even that which he hath. And so if you want revelation, illumination, and understanding of God's word on another level, consistently walk in his word, which is faith. The Hebrew concept is
sing your song to him. I'll keep on singing. I'll keep on singing. I'll keep on singing. Right where you are, just release a melody right where you're standing or sitting and sing to the Lord. Sing to him a new song. Yeah. Sing to him a new song. Don't lose your song, just keep on singing. Don't lose your melody, just keep on singing. Sing a little louder, louder and louder. Hey, sing a little louder, louder and louder. Hey, I sing a little louder, louder and louder. Everybody say, sing a little louder. Sing a little louder,
sing a little louder,
hey, louder and louder. I sing a little louder, sing a little
louder,
louder and louder. Said I sing a little louder,
hey,
louder and louder. Now right there, release that melody, release that melody. Said I sing a little louder, sing a little
louder.
Said I sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder. Louder and louder.
Now keep on singing. Sing a little louder.
Louder and louder.
Keep on singing.
Sing a little louder. Louder and louder.
Hallelujah,
sing a little louder.
Come on and make the devil mad.
Louder and louder.
Louder and louder.